Hi, YouTube. It's nice to be back in good old Louisiana. This house is soon going to belong to somebody else because I'm finally getting it sold. But I'm not here to talk about that. I'm here to talk about finishing your novel. And we've got Camp Nano coming up very soon. And I know a lot of you guys are going to be jumping in on that. And even if you don't do that, NaNoWriMo this November is coming up faster than you think. So if you're planning on participating this year, I'm going to tell you about five things that you need to keep in mind when you are getting ready to draft a novel. And of course, I have my book, Finish the Damn Book, will be coming out on the 28th of April. So keep an eye out for that, because if you need an extra little motivational boost, then that will work perfectly. And it also has some extra information in it on getting ready to publish. But I'm gonna go ahead and dive in here. I got my trusty notebook ready to go so I can keep everything organized. The first thing on the list is an outline. You need to have your story outlined. Now, I know there's some of you that are dragging your feet and you're like, I'm just gonna pants it. It usually works for me, but it doesn't work, because even if you're pantsing it, you already have an outline. The outline is in your head though. So you might have an idea where your character's going, what they're gonna do, what kind of stuff you want them to get into as the story progresses. But until you actually write it down, then all that information is stuck in your head and it's clogging up your creative ability. So do what you need to do and write it down. And I'm really hoping the rain does not affect the video quality too much, because if it does, it's gonna be raining for a little bit. Might have to shoot this tomorrow. Number two, well, is that all on outlines? Yeah, your outline is a compass also. So what's going to happen if you're drafting fast, especially if you're going 2,000 to 3,000 words a day or more, you're going to get to certain points in the story and you're going to get stuck. And when this happens, it's good to have an idea of what the next main bullet point is in the story and where the character needs to be headed. So if you have an outline, you can just glance down at it. You don't have to recall all those little details from memory. You can just glance down at your outline and say, oh, okay, well, he's already fought the first monster and now I need to get him to this other cave so he can discover the secret, blah, 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 whatever, wherever he or she's headed. It's good to know where those little sticking points are, because then you can interject things, like you can drop safes on your character or just do things in the story to kind of get them steering towards where you want them to go, as opposed to them just wandering around in a field full of meadow flowers for another 50 or 60 pages until you get back on track. So everybody's already got an outline. Just write it down. You don't have to make it like 1, 2, 3 Roman numerals, A, B, C, and all that crap. Just write down who the main character is, what he wants, what he has to do to get it, 5 or 6 major plot points, and how you want the climax to evolve. And basically at that point, that's your outline. And if you want to get more detailed with it, you can go in there and interject little pieces and make it better. But it is a lifesaver when you're drafting fast, because you don't want to get stuck without knowing what direction you want the character to go. Number two, targets and goals. Now, this is a big thing with any nano event. You focus mainly on word count, and it's good to have a daily word count target, but especially with Camp NaNoWriMo, where you could be writing anything from poetry to screenplays or anything that's not a novel, it's still a good idea to have some kind of daily goal or something that you can reach for depending on how much time you're allotting yourself that day. So if you're writing a book on poetry, like, you might want to set the goal at 1 to 2 poems a day, and then just do them the same way you would do a novel. Like, if poetry's not coming, just go ahead and write 1 or 2 bad poems to get your mind flowing, and maybe it'll give you an idea for another good one that can actually go in your finished poetry book. Or if nothing else, you at least got something written for the day and you can go sleep easy on that and your brain has done its dump so it can move on to the next step. And just like if you're writing a novel, you want to keep track of word count. And even if you don't meet your word count goal for that day, you can at least have a measuring stick to go off of, and you know where you're at all month. Number three is some kind of device or method to capture daily thoughts. This is critical if you are writing a novel, and especially if you're trying to pants it with a minimal outline. It's good to have a tape recorder, a notebook, an ink pen, some extra scrap paper in your pocket, a thing of post-it notes, or whatever it takes to jot down quick ideas, because through the day you're going to be wanting to think about your novel, and I'm going to talk about that on number four. But when you get ideas for where the story's headed, or maybe you want to start injecting another side plot, or you're thinking about something that's going to happen a few chapters ahead and you don't want to forget it, you want to have some way of getting those ideas down. Now, whether that's a tape recorder or Evernote, personally, I use notebooks and real pens, but however you can do it, always have a way to jot down those ideas. Always have a way to save them, even when you're not at your laptop or your typewriter. Number four. I have this labeled in the notebook as laser focus. Now, that's a little bit, that might sound a little weird, but the idea that I wanted to convey here is be thinking about your story when you wake up. Be thinking about your story on the drive to work. Be thinking about your story while you're at work. Be thinking about your story on the drive home, or while you're in the shower, or while you're eating. When you talk to people about your story and your main character. Don't be afraid. These are your friends. They know you're crazy already, so you're not going to freak them out by talking about your story. As long as you don't overload them, but then you can remind them that you're doing Nano and this is what you're focused on right now, so that they can get on your page or whatever. You listen to their bullcrap all day. They can listen to your story for 5 minutes. That might be me just being a evil, mean writer guy, but hey, it works. So the idea is keep that, the little wheels turning, keep the engine revving. If you're doing poetry, be thinking about certain feelings or emotions that you can maybe try to capture and then write them down on those post-it notes. This way, when you sit down at your laptop and it's time for your writing session to start, you're not sitting there thinking about what you need to write next because you've been thinking about it all day already. You already know where the story's headed and you can just hit the keys with your fingers flying and get it rolling right away. With no downtime, and you're not going to be sitting there researching things or anything of the sort. Just you sit down at your laptop and hit the go button. This is personally how I draft novels. When I'm drafting a novel, whether it's November or not, I always stay. They tell actors to kind of stay in character. Well, writers have to do the same thing, except instead of staying in character, we're staying in the POV of our story. So constantly be thinking about it. Think about the conversations that your character might be having with other characters. Think about the conversations that other characters are having in the background, and just anything else that's going on in the story. Constantly keep that gear turning in your head. And this is like ties back into having the notebook or your tape recorder or Evernote to jot down ideas. Number five, and this is the most important, and this is why Nano is so popular, is accountability. Accountability means that you are not doing this alone, that you have somebody else watching that can say, hey, how many words did you get today? Say you're writing a novel and you want to get 2,000 words a day, have a support group. Have people that you can talk to, people that care, that are interested, and that will give you a kick in the ass when you need one, and will pat you on the back when you need that. But have a group, and Nano provides forums, they provide meeting groups online. Camp Nano gives you your little cabin with your friends, so this allows you to focus all of your writing energy and keep everything sort of on a level playing field. Like, you're all in it with the same goal, you're in the same mindset. These are people that actually understand you. And when you're not doing Nano, the Absolute Right Water Cooler forums is, that's probably the best forum for writing that there is. If you're on Twitter, you can join Writing Challenge. Just go to writingchallenge.org. I'll go ahead and drop a link down below the video, or I might put it up here on one of these little corners or something. But writingchallenge.org is another great group. They're mainly on Twitter, and the goal is 500 words a day or an hour of editing every day. And that'll help you stay consistent on your writing, even when you're not doing nano, it's a good idea to write or be editing or doing something to work on your goal, whatever it is, even if it's not writing. If your goal is painting pictures, then you should be painting every single day for a little bit of time. And that's something I harp on in the book as well. So if you get a chance to check out the ebook at the end of the month, that's another way to go. But as long as you do these five things, sorry for that, YouTube. I was gonna do this whole thing without trying to edit anything, but I don't think you wanna hear my conversation with the local writers guild down here. So where was I? I was doing a rehash of the five things that I talked about, just basically in closing. Number one, have an outline. Stop making excuses. Pantsing is not an excuse for not knowing what kind of story you're going to write. I mean, that's the basic key that's going to keep everything together. And trust me when I say it, if you write without an outline, without any kind of clear direction of where you're headed, and an outline can be as simple as one sentence. It could just be, hero needs to do this or something bad's going to happen. That's an outline. I mean, and that's also a hook when you're trying to come up with a pitch for your book later on. So keep it, focus on it, print it out, tape it to your typewriter, your laptop, and use it. Because that's telling you where the story needs to go. That's the meat that keeps a story cohesive is an outline. So I used to be part of the Panther crowd, and I have been converted because it is a hell of a lot easier to write 50,000 words or more in a month if you have some kind of compass steering you in the right direction. Targets and goals are your other compass. Those are your daily directional points. And that's why it's so important. Just be like, look, I'm gonna get this much done every day. And I usually set two goals, right? I'll set my actual target that I'm aiming for, and then I'll set a minimum. So my minimum might only be 200 words. Be like, as long as I get my 200 words, I've done what I needed to do, and usually by the time I get those 200 words, I can keep going, because then the story's playing in my head and I can roll on to my target, which might be 2,000 or 3,000 words for the night. Some way to capture those random thoughts during the day, crucially important. I keep a notebook in my back pocket and a pen in my little carpenter jeans. So I've always got a way to jot down a story idea. My brother uses a tape recorder. Some people use Evernote on their phone or another kind of app on their phone. It's just good to have a way to get ideas down during the day, even if they're not related to your story, right? Laser focus. Think about your story when you wake up in the morning. Think about it when you're in the shower. Think about it when you're at work. Like, always be thinking about your story and what your characters are up to while you're away from the keyboard. That way, when you sit down to write, you can just go. And number five, accountability, which is the entire reasoning behind Nano to begin with. And there are other groups online that you can join and do while you're doing your Nano story. And if you like them, like, I started with that Twitter group and now I'm an addict. I'm in there every day to report my word count unless I fall asleep on the keyboard. It's good to have writing friends and people that you can talk to about writing, because most people around, well, maybe your life's different, but most of the people that I'm around are not writers generally, and they don't understand. So they'll ask me a bunch of questions, and when I try to explain something, they don't always quite, they're not really jiving on that level. They just ask something simple like, hey, how's the book going? And I turn around and I'm like, which one? So it's good to have people to keep up with and keep you accountable. And I'm gonna try and trim this video down a little bit, because including this little backlog, it's getting kind of long. And again, I'm sorry for that little disjointed part in the middle. I wanted this all be one span, but phones are gonna ring. Thanks for staying with me and looking through this. And if you like what you're seeing, I've got a million tips on my website. I'll drop a link down below. And also, if you're interested and you need an extra kick in the ass to kind of get your creativity going, check out my book. It comes out at the end of the month. It's called Finish the Damn Book. I'll drop a link for that too, so you can pre-order it if you want. If you need it now, go ahead and pre-order it and just send me an email and say, hey, I ordered your book, but I really want to read something now. And I will send you the first seven chapters for free. So that's all the time I got for today. In fact, I think I'm way overboard on time according to the little clock. So I gotta say adieu, goodbye, and we'll see you next time. Have a good night and get some writing done.